This tutorial is going to explain to you what R and RStudio are. There's a lot of R's in that sentence. And is also going to run through how to install these pieces of software on your own computer. So first of all, what are R and RStudio? Well, R is a piece of free software, and its main aim is for doing statistical computing. So in other words, it's a piece of software for doing statistics. Now, R comes with a price, which is that it has an interface like this. And there's a good reason why R is called R, and that is because when you see that interface, you go, ah! But you can make life better in one of two ways. The first way is you can pretend that you're a pirate. And I've borrowed my son's pirate hat and foam cutlass, and then you can go, arr! And that makes everything a lot better. The other thing you can do is to install something called RStudio, which is another piece of software that sits on top of R and takes the pain away. Well, it takes some of the pain away. So you can think of this a bit like a car, in that R is the engine that does all the hard work. But you know, if you wanted to go on a journey, you'd never just sit on the engine or look at the engine or have anything directly to do with the engine if you have any sense. Instead, you sit in the nice cockpit of the car on a comfy seat with a nice little stereo, some nice songs playing, and you know, you drive yourself along. So RStudio is like the comfy cockpit of a car, and R is like the greasy, oily engine that's doing all the hard work. So once you've installed R and RStudio, you can basically forget about R and just use RStudio. So just to recap, R is free software for doing statistics. RStudio is an interface for R that kind of sits on top of it that essentially enhances it with lots of fun things and makes it generally more pleasant to use. So, to get all this working, you first need to install R, and to do that, you go to the R Project website, which is www.rproject.org. So let's have a look at that website. So once you've accessed that website, it should look something like this. Obviously, it might change over time, but the format will be vaguely similar. You want to go to the left-hand menus and click under Download, where it says CRAN. And that takes you to a page that's a rather horrible list of places that you can download R from. And if that looks frightening, just remember, pirate sword, arr, everything's fine again. You can click on any of those. You may as well click on the top one. And that takes you to another page with three links in the top section. One to download R for Linux, which probably most of you don't use. One to download R for Mac, and one to download R for Windows. So let's assume, like me, you're a Mac user. Then you would click on the link that says download R for Mac. And again, another texty page that doesn't make it in any way obvious what you should click on. And that's why I'm doing this video. You want to look at the section latest releases, and you'll see a link here that says r3.6.1.pkg. Now the version number will change if you're viewing this video in the future. It may not say r3.6.1, but it will have a similar format. So it will say r, then a version number. And the important thing is the .pkg. That stands for package, and that's the installation package for Mac. So click on that link, and you'll get a dialog box that says, do you want to open the file and install it, you know, directly, or do you want to save the file? If you save the file, make a note of where you save it, and then go and find it and double click on it, and that will open a standard installation procedure, which I'm going to assume you're familiar with. And otherwise, you can just directly open it from here, and again, it will run you through a direct installation. So that's for Mac. I'm going to cancel that because I already have it installed. Let's go back to the previous page. Now, if you're a Windows user, then you want to click on the link that says download R for Windows. That takes you to a page, which again, not obvious what you should click on, but notice there's a little highlighted thing here. It says install R for the first time. Click on that link. And then that takes you to another page. Again, it will say the version number, which may be different by the time you install this. But the key thing is you want the top link here that says download R, then a version number, in this case 3.6.1 for Windows. Click on that, and same as for a Mac, it will throw up a dialog box. You can either save the file, or I think in Windows it will download it sometimes in your web browser, and you can open it from your download folder. And once that executable file is up and running, it will just run you through a standard installation procedure. If you have any problems, remember we have help desks, and you can come and bring your laptops, ask us stuff, bring a pirate hat and a sword for extra bonus points. And there you go, start using R.